dum 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 dum.
How many hours a day do you stare at your own face?
All the time. I'm always doing selfie.
1.5 hour.
About an hour?
I think.
Maybe 5 hours?
7 hours maybe.
Half an hour, 40 minutes let's say.
Wow, like minimum 3 hours. Minimum.
Worldwide, the average person spends a total of almost 7 hours a day glued to their screens. That constant sight has triggered what doctors are calling a Zoom boom. Je suis... Je suis... The world is seeing a serious rise in demand for cosmetic procedures, and it's largely because people want to change themselves after seeing how they look on screen.
No doubt, lockdown face is a thing. I mean, people used to talk to other people without seeing themselves in the mirror while they talk, and suddenly they do a Zoom meeting and they pay attention to how they look. Suddenly they see the fine details and they see things that bother them.
In the United States, more than 15.5 million cosmetic procedures were performed in 2020, with Americans spending over $9 billion. And here in Israel, the market for Botox and dermal fillers has quadrupled over the last decade. They're considered non-invasive cosmetic procedures.
When people usually think about plastic surgery, they think about, you know, nose jobs, breast augmentation, liposuction. But today, there is a middle ground. You can do aesthetic procedures, which are minimally invasive. On average, it's less expensive than a plastic surgery and way less painful, and with a shorter healing time.
To top it off, because surgery isn't necessary to perform these cosmetic procedures, doctors can perform them anywhere.
Elegance.
Today, some even offer Botox parties to people who want to get work done with their friends.
I have a nail salon, and every day girls come and say, I want to do Botox or fillers, do you do in here? Girls want to look like the filters on Instagram. That's why I'm looking for a doctor to come and make fillers in my nail salon.
So how much does it cost to attain so-called perfection? This is Face It, one of the leading aesthetic clinics in central Israel. Treatments can range anywhere from hundreds to thousands of dollars. Today, they're going to show us what a typical consultation looks like.
What do people most commonly come here to get done?
It depends on the age. Mm-hmm. We got the younger population, and they're more into beautification. They want plump lips sometimes. Mm-hmm. They want to straighten their nose. They want cheekbones that are protruding. And then there's a transitional phase where it's starting to get restorative. You want to fix the beginning of what time does to us. Our main tools in the arsenal are Botox and hyaluronic acid. Classically and typically, the Botox we use on the upper third of the face and hyaluronic acid on the lower two-thirds of the face. Botox in general has the capacity to be preventative when it causes wrinkles. So in terms of Botox, I would recommend just one area of Botox. And then we go downwards. There are your eyes and the tear troughs. We can smooth this line and it would give you a less tired appearance.
Botox costs around $160 a pop, and it lasts for 3 to 4 months before it needs to be reapplied. Hyaluronic acid, otherwise known as fillers, can last for around a year. So if I follow Dr. Yonatan's advice, I'll be paying around $500 a year to maintain Botox in my forehead, and around $550 a year to maintain the fillers under my eyes. This means that I'd need to pay over $1,000 yearly to maintain all of that work.
So, staying young costs money. that it does. What do you say to people who say, is this really good for society? You know, that we have the ability to change ourselves so much like this.
Some people go and get their nails done, we get our hair done, we get a tan, we take care of how we look. It's a tool, and as a tool, it can be misused. But if it's not misused, then it can do wonders.
The demand for achieving a youthful and flawless appearance doesn't seem to be going anywhere, no matter what the moral consequences are. In fact, the global hyaluronic acid-based dermal fillers market is expected to be worth almost $6 billion by 2026. That's just 5 years away.
The question now is how many people will ultimately buy into this vision of beauty? Would you?